एवरीवन, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल एंड यू आर फाइन एट होम एंड एंजॉयिंग मैथ्स क्लासेस. सो इट्स अगेन नाउ टाइम फॉर मैथ्स लेक्चर. लेट अस बिगिन. ऑल ऑफ यू ओपन योर बुक पेज नंबर 44. ऑल ऑफ यू ओपन योर बुक पेज नंबर 44. इन आवर लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव कवर्ड प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ सब्ट्रैक्शन एंड आई गिव यू a homework as I give you activity as homework. So I hope you all are doing okay. So now let's start today with page number 44. So there's interesting question given over there at the top of the page. So the question is, the greedy gold bean has stolen Fairy Face Butter Cookies. Find out his name by mentally counting backwards and decode the letters of the alphabet they stand for. So here there is a special or unique kind of question for you all. By that you have to decode a name. In this question you have to decode a name. Very interesting. So let's see. Basic question. How many letters are there in alphabet? How many letters are there in alphabet? Very good. 26 letters are there. 26 letters are there. So each letter A, B, C, D and so on up to Z, each letter is having, if I give A one number, B two number and so on like this, each number is having each letter is having a number, like A, what comes after A is B, C, D and so on. Likewise we can give give one number to each letter, as 1 for A, 2 for B, 3 for C, 4 for D and so on. See, likewise they have given in the book, 1 for A, 2 for B, 3 for C, like 20 for T, 22 for B and so on, 26 for Z, like this. Okay, so here what we have to do, we will solve some subtraction question, and suppose if by solving the given question I got 4 as answer. So I will find out number 4. Number 4 is here and D, number 4 is representing D. So in the place of number 4 I will write D. Suppose after solving subtraction question I am getting 25. So number 25 is representing Y. So I will write Y on the place of 25. I hope you are getting what I am trying to explain. So let's do it. They have given us hint also. They have given us hint, or they have given us two letters. One is J and another is B. So let us decode the number of lines they have given. Let us decode the whole name. We have to decode a name. So the very first they have done for us is 11 minus 1. So the subtraction property, whenever 1 is subtracted from a number it gives previous number. So what is previous number of 11? Very good. 10 is previous number of 11. So in your book all of you check which 10 is representing which digit, which letter 10 is representing. All of you check in your book. Very good. 10 is representing J. So we will write J here. Okay. Now the next one. 10 minus 1. So what is the previous number of 10? Again we will apply subtraction property. So 9 is the previous number of 10. So we will write 9. Now we will check which letter 9 is representing. In your book check which letter 9 is representing. Very good. 9 is representing letter I. So we will write I. Okay. Now the next, 9 minus 2. 9 minus 2. Minus 2 means we have to count backward 2 times. So let us count. one time backward, we will get 8. And if we will count backward one more time, we will get 7. 9, 8, 7. So we will write 7 here. Now let's check which letter 7 is representing. All of you, you also check in your book as I am checking in my book. Letters number 7 is representing letter G. So we will write G in the box. Okay. Now the next one is 8 minus 6. 8 minus 6. Okay, so now let's count 6 times backward. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We stopped at 2, it means 2 is our answer. So check all of you in your book which letter number 2 is representing. Which letter number 2 is representing? Yes, number 2 is representing letter B. That they have given us in hint also. Letter B, they had given us in hint also. Okay, so the last one is 6 minus 5. 6 minus 5. So let me write counting one more time. So 6, number 6 is here. We have to count backward 5 times. So let's count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now we stopped at number 1. So we will write number 1. Now all of you check which letter number 1 is representing. Which letter number 1 is representing? Number 1 is representing letter, number 1 is representing letter A. Okay, so the name is J I G B A, and J and B they have given us in hint, so the name is Jigba. The name is Jigba. Okay, so this was the unique kind of question book has given for you. I hope now you all are getting how to do it. It was very much simple. We just need to count backward. Now we are going to learn a new concept today. Which is subtraction on the number line. One more thing, this question with which we have just solved will remain in book only. Okay, do not need to note it down in classwork copy. Now subtraction on number line, what the topic is. Suppose this is the number line. Now this is number 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and so on. Okay. Now suppose we need to solve 9 minus 4. Suppose equation is given 9 minus 4. So how to do subtraction on number line? So first of all, we will find the number 9. Number 9 is here. So we reach to number 9. Now minus 4. Minus 4 is there. So we will count backward 4 times. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here we have stopped at 5. So our answer is number 5. See, it is very simple. 9 minus 4 was there. So we jump to the number 9. Then minus 4. Minus 4 is there. So we jumped 4 times backward and here we stopped at number 5. So we are writing number 5 as our answer. Okay. So this is given in your book also, page number 44. Question number B. A they have solved, A they had solved. Let me explain that one also. Do not need to note it down in class work copy. This will remain in book only. So I hope you all are trying to get how to do subtraction on number line. So let me make number line one more time. This is the number line. Although number line must be a straight line, even I am writing by running hand, but number line is a straight line and the distance between all the numbers are same. Okay, so the question they had given us is 18 minus 30. So the very first step is, first of all, we will find out, or we will jump to the number 18. We will jump to the number 18. So let's jump. Now we have jumped to the number 18. Now minus 13. Minus 13, it means we will go backward 13 times. So let's start. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So we stopped at number 5. So this is our answer. So we will write number 5. See, it is very simple. Now we'll do part D. Part C. Part C is 17 minus 6. So the very first step is jumping to the given number. So number is 17. So we jump to number 17. Now Minus 6 is there. So we will go backward 6 times. So let's start. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So we stop at number 11. It means 11 is our answer. So see how simple it is doing subtraction on number line. So let's do some exercise questions based on number line. So all of you open your copies. This will remain in your book only. Now open your copies. All of you open your copies. So first of all, you will write heading, which is exercise 3.1. Exercise 3.1. Now write question number 1. I am giving you time. Write question number 1. Subtract on the number line. Subtract on the number line. All of you write question. I am giving you time. All of you write question. So now I hope you all had written question in your class work copy. Now we will start from part A. So first of all, we will make number line. All of you make number line using ruler or scale. Do not make by running hand as I am making. You all will make number line using a straight line. Okay, so now starting from 0, we will mark all the numbers up to 20, and we remember distance between all the two numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Okay, all of you make proper number line. So now I hope you all made number line properly. Now the question is 14 minus 5. The question is 14 minus 5. So first of all, we will jump to the number 14. Now minus 5 is there, so we will come backward 5 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I stopped here at number 9. It means 9 is the answer. Okay, so this is how you will write in the copy. Although I will provide PDF also. From which you can write. So 14 minus 5 is equals to 9. Now let's do part B. So students, I will not make number line again and again, but you have to make number line in all the questions separately. Okay, now part B again, all of you make number line. If you are not able to make line with me, so you can pause the video and make line and then again play the video. Very simple. So part B is 7 minus 4. So first of all, we will jump to the number 7. Okay. Minus 4. Minus 4 means we will come backward 4 times. 1, 2, 3. So we stopped at number 3. It means 3 is our answer. See how simple it is, how simple subtraction is, how simple it is to solve subtraction question. Just see the number, jump to the number and come backward the number of times, whatever the second number is, and get the answer. Very simple. Now, part C. So, all of you stop writing. See part C first. Okay. So, what is part C? Part C is 13 minus 7. Okay, so what we will do, first of all we will jump to the number 13. So let's jump. Now we jump to number 13 minus 7. Minus 7 is there, it means we will come backward 7 times. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we stopped at number 6. It means 6 is our answer. Okay. Now one more thing. Complete after completion of every question. We'll put a line like this. And one more time, I am reminding you all. Do not make lines by running hand. Always use scale or ruler. Okay. So now, after part C, we will do part D. After part C, we will do part D. Okay, now part D is 9 minus 5. So what we will do, first of all we will jump to the number 9. So we jumped to number 9. Now minus 5 is there, so we will come backward 5 times. So let's do it. 1 2 3 4 5. So we stopped at number 4. It means number 4 is our answer. Okay, all of you note it down quickly. Note it down quickly, neatly, and with cleanliness, okay? In beautiful handwriting. Now, although I am going to provide you PDF of notes also, so do not worry if you are not able to write with me. Don't worry. So the next or the last part of the exercise. Zero, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and 9. And from 10 onwards, number line is already there. All of you make proper number line using ruler or a scale. So now I hope you all made number line properly. So part E is 12 minus 8. See how you have to write in the copy. First of all, left to the marginal line, you will make and you will write the whatever the question number is. Here question number is E. So we will write E left to the marginal line. Now with using ruler or scale, you will make a proper straight line, and then starting from 0 you will write all the numbers with equal distance. The distance between all the two numbers must be equal. Okay, now 12 minus 8. So first of all we will jump to the number 12. So let's jump. Yeah, we are at number 12. Okay, make proper triangle like this. So now we are at number 12 minus 8. Minus 8 is there, so we will come backward 8 times. So let's come. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 and 8. Now we are stopped at number 4. It means our answer is number 4. So we will write number 4 in the box. So see students, how simple it is doing subtraction on number line. Subtraction on number line is very much simple. Now what you need to do, first of all make a straight line, then mark all the numbers on the line, make it number line. Then jump to the first given number and then come backward number of times equal to the second number, and where you stop there is your answer. So see how it is simple. It is very much simple to do subtraction on number line. So in chapter number 3 we learn subtraction by counting backward, then we learn some properties, then we did a activity based on subtraction, and today we learn subtraction on number line. So keep revising all the things. See, we have learned subtraction properties in previous lectures. So daily at least one time read all the properties. Daily read at least one time all the properties so that you can learn them. If you will read one time daily, easily you will learn all the properties. So students, we will meet in next lecture. This is all for today's lecture. Till then, bye bye students. Stay home, stay safe, and keep practicing.